It was wonderful. There were a lot of friends of us there, and members of the Democratic Opposition Movement at that time already just started to grow. Explains that why this is very subversive. This work, which represents the big Hungary, then it was Irradenta, they went to Transylvania back. But all these pieces, they are referring to. But this is also by everyone, this is an object like this, or the mess, Brad Mills.
We were lucky in a way.
Yeah. Those hippie times.
Yeah.
So these are documents from this chapter period, and then we also brought some documents that have projects of done with Ray Johnson. This was a relates to an opening that Miklós Erdély did on his exhibition. So this was in 76, he had an exhibition, and Miklós Erdély opened this with this flag signals of the Navy flag signals. And then when Miklós died, he repeated or made an homage to it, and there was a flag in the Navy. Very strong. These simple signs are, if you look at it in a political context, in a certain time, they are very interesting because they are very reduced in communication. So then it's
so you have to get to the point.
This one is a very complex.
This was 1939? No, it was maybe 1939 Expo in Paris.
In Paris, yes. Yeah. This was Cavallini.
Yeah, I know. He was in,
yes,
in
with a slight difference that we when he came, he said, okay,
I like the idea,
but we are not interested in that he writes his own story on our dresses. Yeah, so we asked him to write the names of art history. These are Soviet tourists on the square. they immediately recognized
them,
and gave small learning budgets to everyone. This is the summary of this. We had an art review in 83-84, and it had 11 issues. And this was a small newsletter that we started. The first issue was like this, and the other ones, they were photocopied. So it was a kind of mail art newsletter, news.
So I think
this was the most important to be information was at that time.
Yeah. I mean, there was no other way. You cannot travel. The only thing you can travel were the postcards.
Yeah. In 87, on the 100th anniversary of Duchamp, it was at the university, and we announced an exhibition, a call. We sent out a call for commemorate, and a lot of participants we had for this show. We could produce this catalog some years ago. So on the,
but based on this material, We
promised to do the catalog, but we couldn't at that time. Yeah. And there were some lectures also. So quite a lot of art historians were invited to these lectures, and they all could speak 5 minutes. And there was a chess clock that measured 5 minutes, and they were stopped. It was in 87.
Where?
It was in the Museum of Fine Arts.
Yeah, I can see that, but in Budapest.
In Budapest.
So by 87 this was possible to do something.
There was a trick. So it couldn't be said. So the day of the Museum of Fine Arts started to do an exhibition of private collections. And this was exhibited as a private collection. It was not said that this is art pool. And it's at the beginning it said that this was the first catalog of artist stamps that we did. This was in 82. This was, yes. this has its story, how it could be printed, because at that time this was not possible. But everyone was working in the back. And so on a weekend, the printers of this very small printing house, they were working black for us. And, and this was the invitation that Galantai printed for the 73 in Balatonbogra. And the Hungarian authorities were very upset about this, because it was, it looked like a Western invitation. So they described that three languages. It's small maps, and how could he do it? This was the first visual poetry exhibition in Hungary, this one. And I think the first sound poetry event in Hungary, but it got a new one in Hungary.
Maybe there is no pen on the